Привет, друзья! Как дела? My name is Fedor, and today you will learn 11 Russian curse words. How to use them, when to use them, and what they mean. But of course, cuss words is like a small, very small part of our Russian language. Maybe it's the most expressive one, but it's still small. And if you want to speak Russian on a basic level, then join our BeFluent Camp. It's an 8-week course that starts on February the 6th, and by the end of it, you will speak Russian on the basic level. We guarantee you that, all right? We prepare everything for you, grammatical topics, speaking exercises, pronunciation, listening, vocabulary exercises, that you can develop your Russian and speak Russian on the basic level, so that when you go to Russia, you won't have any problems speaking on the street, describing what you want, and maybe asking for some directions. All right, join up. We are almost full, maybe like 85% full of the camp and the limit of the students. So join up is the first link in the description. See you there. But now talking about curse words. Curse words in Russian is a very interesting topic. We have a whole bunch of curse words, maybe like 100, 150, depending on the region that you go to in Russia. And today, I'll share with you 11 of them that are probably most common in any region. Maybe they're not most common, but they are most diverse. They cover the majority of curse words topics. All right? In Russian, 95% of all curse words derive from блять, хуй, пизда, and ебать. These are the stem words that are used to create almost every single Russian curse word. All right, and today you will find out exactly what all of them mean and a couple of words that derive from these words. All right, let's start with блять. Блять means like, oh shit. Okay, well, let's say you're walking somewhere, right, and you hit your toe off a chair and you go, oh, ah, блять, that hurt. Oh shoot, that hurt. All right, so блять means that. Блять doesn't have its own literal meaning, but it adds some emotion to our statements. For example, we can also say, ты где, блядь, был? Where the fuck were you? Alright, in this sentence, блядь means the fuck. Where the fuck were you? If we did not have блядь, it would have been just the dry, where were you? Right? It doesn't have as much of emotion and meaning into it. Alright, so we add блядь to add that emotion to our statements. It can be added to any statement whatsoever if you want to simply show some more emotion. Alright? Another word that comes from this one is блять, but with a different spelling. They are pronounced the same way, but this one has a D at the end of it. And this one means a whore. Somebody, most likely this is referring to a lady, unfortunately, but of course guys can be whores too. And so this one describes a person of a very active sexual life who is not really monogamous, who has sex with many people. All right, a whore. So, for example, I can say, мне это, блядь, не нравится. I don't like that whore, okay? Something like that. Next word to discuss is хуй. Хуй means a dick. An actual male, you know, sex organ. So, хуй, we, of course, can call our private parts хуй. But this one can also be used to insult a man. We can call a man хуй. Okay, for example, I can say, что этот хуй здесь делает? What is this dick? What is this dude doing here? Okay, and I'm insulting him by calling him a dick. Okay, by calling him хуй. Alright, so this word can be used in multiple meanings. A word that comes from хуй is нахуй. Нахуй means for fucking what? For example, you had a birthday and a friend of your parents, for example, comes to you and gives you a gift that's useless. You don't really need it. Let's say, okay, I have like a gift wrap right here. They give you a gift and then in the evening you come to your friend and say, look at what they gave me. Нахуй мне это нужно? What the fuck do I need it for? Okay, so нахуй in this case means what the fuck. Okay, when something is completely useless, we use this word нахуй. Next up is похуй. And похуй is a part of a phrase мне похуй, which means I don't fucking care. I don't think we use it in any other expression besides мне похуй or тебе похуй, which means you don't care. I don't think it can be a part of any other contextual sentence as a whole. So we typically use a personal pronoun in dative case, like мне, тебе, etc. with this word похуй. Okay, so I can say мне похуй на погоду. I don't fucking care about the weather. Let's say it's New Year's Eve and I want to go out and somebody says, it's cold outside. Мне похуй на погоду. I don't care about the weather. Let's go. All right? Next word, next stem word is пизда. Пизда, opposite of хуй, means a pussy, a female private part. Just like хуй, we can call the private part пизда, or we can insult a lady by calling her пизда. Okay, for example, это пизда очень странная. That bitch is very strange, okay? So maybe you're at the party somewhere and you don't know somebody and you call, hey, that bitch is very crazy. You know, I don't want to go around her. So something like that, okay? A word that comes from this one is пиздец. And пиздец means we fucked. Alright, we messed up, something bad happened, we're fucked. Okay, for example, он приехал слишком рано. Это был пиздец. He came very early. It was a disaster. It was a fucking disaster, okay? Maybe it was the parents of your friend and you were partying at the house, smoking weed or whatever, and the parents came too early and it's like, oh, fuck, we fucked. Пиздец. Alright? Another word that comes from пизда is пиздеть. And пиздеть means to lie. Or like, to fucking lie, okay? For example, I can say, я знаю правду, а ты пиздишь. I know the truth, but you're lying, alright? So you can tell somebody that they're fucking lying because you know the truth, okay? As you can see, guys, how do we come from we fucking doomed to you're fucking lying from a simple word, pussy? How does a pussy really determine all of these different words? Well, the only similarity is the spelling. I don't think the meaning really transfers with these cuss words, so a lot of the cuss words, they describe different things about Russian life, and they don't necessarily have to come from the same meaning as the origin. Alright, so kind of when you go explore more Russian cuss words, be ready for that. And we have a last stem for today, which is ебать. And ебать means to fuck, okay? But this one doesn't mean to have sex, this means to fuck someone, when one person is fucking the other, okay? So, but also this word ебать, I don't think it's almost ever used in its direct meaning. We use other words instead of this one, but ебать can also be used as блять, like, ah, shit, oh, ебать, right? When you hit your, like I said, your toe off a chair, you go, ah, shit, it hurt, right? We can say блять, or we can say ебать in this case as well. The word that comes from ебать is ебаться. Now, this one is to have sex, okay? This one is commonly used to talk about having sex. For example, когда я вошел, они ебались. When I came in, they were fucking, okay? Something like that, right? They were having sex when I came in. That's what this word describes. And the last word for today is ебанутый. Ебанутый means fucking crazy, okay? For example, your friend did something crazy, like just out of common sense stuff, and it's just bad thing. And you can say, "Чё ты сделал? Ты ебанутый? What the fuck did you do? Are you crazy?" All right, something like that. So now you guys know 11 Russian curse words. You can use them now freely, but please be careful and don't use them out of context or in a bad situation. For now, I would just say simply be aware of them. Do not use them with a person unless you are comfortable with them, because you might get hurt, all right, if you use it in a bad situation. I'm gonna see you guys over at BeFluentCamp. Learn how to speak Russian with us.